At only 19 years old, my next guest, Jenny, was shocked to learn she had a potentially life-threatening health condition, usually found in people more than twice her age. Her diagnosis was so serious, her parents joined in the changes Jenny had to make to save her life. Here's Jenny's story.
When I was 19, I found out that my liver was inflamed. I had stage 3 non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, otherwise known as Nash. I felt very scared because I didn't know what it was. Sorry.
When I realized it was Jenny's diet that contributed to her illness, I felt like an unfit mom.
Over here is all the meals that we're gonna have for different days of the week. My mom was very involved. It was her idea to start the whiteboard that we have with all our meals on it. One of the first things I noticed is that I wasn't tired anymore. I had a lot of energy, which I thought, is this how I was supposed to feel this whole time? Nash is a lifelong disease. It will never go away. I'll always have it. This is a daily challenge, but learning to overcome it makes me healthier.
Well, joining me are Jenny and my very good friend, Dr. Frieda Lewis Hall from Pfizer. Thank you both for being here. Also joining us in the audience is Jenny's mother, Lisa, so I appreciate you being here as well. Now, Jenny, you were diagnosed with stage 3 NASH, a liver disease, at only 19. So what were your first thoughts when you got the news?
Well, Dr. Phil, I felt very confused, very frustrated, and I also felt very scared because I had never heard of NASH. So when my doctor told me I was on stage 3, it felt like an early death sentence.
So Dr. Frieda, what is NASH? And is someone as young as Jenny susceptible to disease? But just tell us about it.
NASH stands for non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. Now this occurs when fat accumulates in the liver, and this buildup causes cell damage, inflammation, and scarring of the liver or cirrhosis. Now this is not caused by alcohol, and it can be life-threatening because it may lead to liver failure and liver cancer. NASH typically causes liver damage in people around the age of 50. So Jenny is much younger than the typical person that's affected by this disease. So what are some of the risk factors? They include hypertension, being overweight or obese, having type 2 diabetes, and also genetic factors, certain pre-existing conditions, and some lifestyle habits can also increase the risk among younger people.
How does somebody know if they have NASH? I mean, what are the symptoms?
Yeah, so NASH is usually an inconspicuous disease and has few or no outward symptoms in early stages. Here are a couple of symptoms that may be a signal that you would want to go and see your doctor. For example, having discomfort in the upper right side of the abdomen, severe tiredness, weakness, or weight loss.
Okay, so upper right side of the abdomen.
Upper right side.
And then just lethargy. Okay,
yes.
So what's the treatment?
There is no medicine that is approved to either stop or reverse the liver damage caused by NASH. So what Jenny's doing is really the key, and that is to find and maintain a healthy lifestyle, which includes eating healthy food and exercise.
Right. So Lisa, when you learned that Jenny could be headed for really serious problems with her liver, you had to make dramatic lifestyle changes, right, for the whole family.
Absolutely. So when we found out about Jenny's diagnosis, I immediately scoured the internet for reliable sources. We found that clean eating, or food in its original form, and exercising was the best for Jenny.
So how is your health now?
Well, I lost about 30 pounds right after I was diagnosed, and I did gained some weight back, but now I'm back on track, doing well. I've already started to lose more weight.
Right.
And the best part about all of this is I went from late stage 3 to early stage 1.
Like your mom is saying, it's just a lifestyle. You just have to decide, okay, I'm gonna just change the way I live, the pattern, the way I live. And if you'd like to learn more about Nash or any other health-related issues, one of my favorite websites is gethealthystayhealthy.com. It's research-based, it's science, it really gives you the information.
Well, thank you. And of course, while you're there, you can sign up for a monthly newsletter.
Yeah, and the monthly newsletter is great. It gives you stuff that you didn't think you were interested in, and you start reading it and you can't put it down, right? Look, I want to thank all of my guests today, and a special thanks to Dr. Frieda Lewis-Hall.